day, dueling demonstrationists. I'm Unsilent, and we're on the air with more Demonstration Derby. In this episode, we've got a special Star Wars-themed Demonstration Derby as we look at classic and not-so-classic Star Wars games demos from about 2000 to 2005 we're looking at this time out. And we're starting, starting at the low end, actually, with Star Wars Episode 1 Jedi Power Battles, right somewhere in the 50s on the PS1, actually somewhere in the 70s on the Dreamcast. I didn't even know there was a Dreamcast version of this game until I, looked into this. But we've got Star Wars Episode 1 Jedi Power Battles. This episode will start us on the droid control ship. As you can see, the playable characters, Adi Gallia, Qui-Gon, Mace Windu, Obi-Wan, Plo Koon, and, three of them, the three that aren't in the movie, have their own colored lightsabers. And I believe in the Clone Wars animated series, both Adi Gallia and Plo Koon had blue lightsabers, while Mace had his famous purple lightsaber. Anyway, let's get started. So the Trade Federation battleship, fight your way through the Federation droid control ship, defeat the droids who oppose you. It's a pretty straightforward hack and slash game, developed by LucasArts. You've got your quick attack, you've got your vertical slice, and you've got your power attack. And you trot around. This walking animation is just terrible. Just trot around. Tra-la-la-la-la. It's a terrible animation. And it doesn't feel particularly... Now, I don't think that's an emulator thing. That's why it's slowed down there. I think that's... This is off running off an actual demo disc that I have. So, I missed my run, and there we go, big spiral splash like that. Now, this is running off an actual demo disc I have, so it's a thing. There we go, took his arm off too. So yeah, it just always seems to have frame hiccups. It never seemed, the demo never seemed well optimized. There we go. Oh, took it in half. The blue droids, which I believe were pilot droids. There we go. There's a block button that lets you, block. And if you time it right, you could pop droids back in the face with a blaster bolt. There's also... I believe there has to be a combo system, though. I believe there's also a block stamina bar, but I could be wrong. I remember getting good with the block in the demo by the time I was done with it. But yeah, the idea is that you just run around chopping up droids. Nope. Oh, right, I forgot you could do that. For bonus points, you can tear the place up. Get extra points. Not showing up particularly cleanly on the screen, but... Oh, yeah, your attacks. You've got your quick attack on square. You've got your vertical slice on X, and your big power attack on triangle. Yep. Yeah, everything feels like it's... Compared to the movies, everything feels like you're moving through sludge with Obi-Wan. That's my big problem right now, is I don't remember it feeling that slow. But it could just be a function of... Could be a function of emulation, it could be a function of... Oh, I took out the big screen. I didn't even know you could do that. I never... But then again, I didn't know you could do that. Until about 30 seconds ago. That was actually a good trick. I didn't have to do any spinning. But speaking of which, do you want to see a good trick? Oh, there's a checkpoint. I remember that. No, that wasn't a good trick. You want to know what's a good trick? That's a good trick. So is that. Spinning. Oh, he blocked it! The bastard! Where was I? Yeah. Spinning. That is a good trick. And everyone likes spinning because it is a good trick. In fact, it will come in handy a little later on in the program. Well, the movie, anyway. Missed. Missed. I'm not very good at this whole jumping thing. That was an annoying thing. Bad enough I can't get the jumping right, but now I get knocked out of midair by a shot. Oh, look at us go! Nobody wants to jump off the edge. Oh. I'm pulling away from him slightly. Oh, he's following me. Oh, I didn't even talk. Forgot about that.
There they are. Get them.
And there it is, the end of the demo. It's a short little demo, but a demo nonetheless. This is the end of the demo, right? Yes, there it is. There you go. One or two player action across 10 action-packed levels. Never did play this. The full version of. So it's like, well. Could play Plo Koon, that would be nice. Dave Filoni would appreciate that. And let's jump a little ahead. In 2000 to Star Wars Demolition. Or the PS1 and Dreamcast as well. This is sort of a... Well, Jedi Power Battles was a hack and slash. This is... Well, Twisted Metal, really. Everyone did. I think even the WWE had like a Twisted Metal knockoff. Because this is a demo. This was released... This one I found online as its own standalone demo disc. So yes, there were demos of Star Wars Demolition sent out for some reason. Now the only level we have available to us is Tatooine Desert. Hi Jabba. Oh, I'll be a son of a Bith. There's some Bith. But we've also got a land speeder piloted by Wade Vox. A pod racer, an AAT droid tank, a STAP, an ATST,
ATSTs, ATSTs,
a desert skiff. I guess that's sort of like some of what Jabba's goons were running around with in Return of the Jedi. Snow speeder, a twin pod police craft from Cloud City. And a Rancor pack of yeet. I guess that's swoop bike. A Boba Fett. A speeder bike. And a Darth Maul Sith speeder. And then back to the land speeder. Let's do the land speeder. We are on Tatooine. And I guess up the tunnel and into the arena. Now the problem with this demo is that I actually have no idea what the controls are, so most of this will be guesswork. So there's a high likelihood that we're all going to die. But isn't that half the fun when you're watching me play video games? Well, we've managed to slowly whittle down that AAT down to looking badly damaged. Just standing here. Oh no, the snow speeder's on me. No, he's literally on me. Blow that up and we've got, I guess, a secondary weapon? Oh, that's a snow speeder again. Let's see what the... I think these things are armor pickups. Or ammo pickups, or... Oops. Ran into that, somebody got blown up in there. Hey, is that Aura Singh? Oh, look, there's that AAT again. Hey, time he took down the AAT battle tank destroyed. Now somebody's over here in this blue bar. Oh, it's still Aura Singh. Hang on, we gotta take down. I wanna take down Aura Singh so I can use the line from Solo. Oh, there goes Aura Singh.
Pretty sure the fog killed her.
You did the galaxy a favor that day. Me especially. I owed her a lot of money.
Oh, hey, look, it's a crate dragon skeleton. Or was it crate dragon skeleton? Oh no, we've got that. You think a snowspeeder's got harpoons and tow cables? Well, wait until he sees the might that is my tractor beam. He can jump. I've got a gonk droid. Sweet. He stole my weapon. You bastard. Oh, he... I was gonna say, and he's shooting backwards. Or is he shooting forwards? It's hard to tell, we've mangled him a bit. Well, he was shooting forwards. We just mangled him. That got him. Is that it? GG! Aha. You win! A winner is you. And from 2005, it's Lego Star Wars video game. Based on the new prequel trilogy. See, it's a Lego game. And actually, it was quite popular. It's quite well received. They did the Lego Star Wars, and they did the second one, which was the... which was the original trilogy. They did the complete saga, everything together. We're supposed to be getting the Skywalker saga. I don't know if that's going to be like this original one, like the original six plus. They did a Force Awakens one. And then they've got the... I don't know if that's going to include like all of the original stuff or it's all going to be built from scratch. I'm kind of interested to see. I was gonna say, I remember the lines from the Phantom Menace video game. Captain, look! Oh well, a bit late to look. Oh yeah. I have always heard that these Lego games are pretty funny, actually. So we get to start as Qui-Gon, we can switch it up to Obi-Wan. I haven't quite figured out all the controls because it doesn't like the Xbox One controller, so I'm just kind of fumbling about with the controls and hoping for the best. I figured out that that the force is on what I've got is the B button. Attacking is on Y. You can switch on the A. And X is the jump. That's Obi-Wan's got this. Look at his moves. Better with the lightsaber in this game. Oh, okay. There's switches. You got this, Obi-Wan. Oh, look, we got a... Is it like a Camtomo or stuff, or... Oh, Lego canisters. In this demo for a super secret game code. Well, I was gonna say it's not as cool as a Camtomo of things. Now, Camp Tomo, which I realize is not a thing that a lot of you guys would know outside of, well, you would definitely know what that is if you were in Canada, the US, the Netherlands, or on the high seas, because it does get brought up on The Mandalorian. It's basically a storage unit that looks decidedly like a, an ice cream maker. Now the idea is to get the droid to open certain doors. This is as far as I've played, just to make sure I could figure out the controls. After this, I have no idea what's going on. We're getting this droid to open up some doors so we can move forward. I was gonna say, this is the sum of my experience with Lego games. It's just, you just blow stuff up and eventually things happen. Oh. Or you build things with the Force. So, they've got up the ventilation shaft. And get a little practice in. Fortunately, it's very forgiving. With that. Hang on. I know how this works. I was gonna say, I've watched Revenge of the Sith. I was gonna say, I think I've also read in the book somewhere that these may be ray shielded, but not in fact shielded from lightsabers. And in fact, they aren't. I love the sound effects. The sound effects are right, though, for cutesy little Lego game. And all the sound effects are pretty spot on. I have to give them some credit there. I wasn't expecting that. There we go. Oh, this has to be the end of the level. That's how we get to Naboo. As we hop aboard the droid transport. Obi-Wan is a little young for stealth to be working. I'm gonna say, this is the, right when you boot up, you get the same trailer. Some Kamino action with the Jedi mullet. Oh yeah, because this came out in 2005, this would be novel to have a game based on Revenge of the Sith. Although I understand the actual proper Revenge of the Sith game was actually reasonably good. Now see, this would be a game I wouldn't mind doing an LP of. Like the proper, like, complete saga, or maybe the Skywalker saga when it comes out. Oh, there's the pod racing scene in there too. That was pretty cool. This Wizard Annie. So they master the power of the Force, or at least just building stuff with Legos. Same thing. And we get the Rogue One scene in here. 10 years before it actually happened. Well, not 10, 11, but you get what I'm saying. Oh, April 2005. Well, no wonder why it would have been novel, because this came out a month before the movie did. Makes me wonder how video game development works. If you're developing a game based on a movie, do you get to see the movie in progress? Do you get to read scripts and see storyboards and arts and stuff? Or do you just, I wonder how you, or do you get both? And jumping back 3 years, I thought we'd have a little fun at the end. It's Star Wars Jedi Knight 2 Jedi Outcast. Now this game I have played, a demo I've not played. It is a time of relative peace in the galaxy, 8 years have passed since the Empire's defeat at the Battle of Endor, but the New Republic still struggles to restore order and vanquish its enemies. After defending the Valley of the Jedi from the evil jerk,
spoiler,
and nearly falling to the dark side himself, former Jedi Knight Kyle Katarn has severed his connection with the Force and returned to his mercenary ways. With his longtime partner Jan Ors, Kyle continues to aid the Republic in the fight against the Imperial Remnant. As the Remnant launches its latest gambit to regain control of the galaxy, Kyle and Jan have been sent by the New Republic to investigate the planet Kejim, home to a long-dead Imperial outpost. Now, I do believe that is actually the title crawl from the game proper. I don't think this has the demo's title crawl, if the demo had a title crawl. What I'm doing is the solution here is I downloaded the demo map, so we're going to be playing the proper demo map, even if it isn't the demo proper. And they're going to have a little fun with that. I don't remember the first cutscene all that well, so I don't know if this is actually the original cutscene. It might be the cutscene from the game proper. But this is not Kejim. Kejim Outpost is the first level of Jedi Outcast. So you'll hear me refer to this constantly, so I'm hoping to have a little fun. And just have to see how it goes. It's Jan and the Ravensclaw. Named after the new developers since it moved out of LucasArts development. But LucasArts was still publishing it.
Be ready for a quick pickup. I've got a feeling that things are about to get pretty nasty around here.
Give me a shout when you find out what's going on.
Will do.
My friend Kyle Katarn not doing things.
See what that was. Who is it?
Oh, new force power, new objective. Info. So make your way through the Remnant base to reach Jan and the Ravensclaw. Engage Remnant forces in the area. If you get force powers off the hop, you don't get that in the game proper. You know what we're going to do. Oops, that wasn't it. Let's see. Dev map all. Set force power. Set force.
Have you seen the new T-17?
3?
Yeah, looks like they modified the ion engine.
Yeah, okay, I think. Oh no, that isn't. It was F5. Oh, we don't have all the weapons. We have a lightsaber. We have the lightsaber. And that's about the... And a blaster, and... That's about it. Alright, now, how good do you think my aim is? Pretty good. You've got... Sadly, what I was hoping for is I'd have all the weapons. No Wilhelm screams, a little disappointing. Alright. We'll just, we'll try and top up as much as we can with the Force Heal, but... I was gonna say...
That doesn't sound good.
Well, that's because it isn't, Kyle. It sounds like a probe droid. There we go. He's running. Ain't gonna last very long. Uh-oh. Run, Forrest. And what's the decapitation one, or the... What's the really good, What's the really good one for all the, all the dismember... What's the dismemberment code in here? Hang on a second. Uh-oh. No hanging on. Just blow him up by doing that. Okay. So apparently, I've seen a few different versions of this, but it should be G_saber realistic combat. One. We'll see how that works. Then we start hacking up stormtroopers. Got the the fleshette. I was gonna say it was a repeater, but guess not. Instant use med pack. We'll recharge very quickly. Get our shields up. And you can, one of the neat little things is you can claw up the walls. Now I need a supply key for that. Right. This is ammo, but we seem to be topped up on all ammo that we require.
That's a lot.
Now we need a security key. Well, where will one obtain a security key? Oh! I think we found the dismemberment. Oh! Yeah, I think we did a good job of that. Alright. Hang on a second, wait for it. We'll just drop some lightning on that. And we took off his leg too for good measure. Unfortunately, I don't think that found us a security key, but we can continue trying. We will continue trying until we find a security key. And if we don't find a security key, then oh well. Oh right, I don't think I went this way. The lift.
Mon Mothma was right, Jen. Remnant troops are crawling all over this place.
Well, that should bring the Republic running.
Prep the ship for takeoff.
Okay, I'll wait here. Don't take all day.
I think we got the dismemberment on.
Uh-oh.
Give up, Rebel!
Kyle, I've got some trouble here.
Great.
Now, it was your first clue. So we gotta reach the Ravensclaw, and we've gotta lower the force field that's holding us into Hangar Bay 2.
The exit's blocked by the current.
Thought I saw someone there, but I guess not. Alright. We'll be fine. We can't go through that. Now, all these...
Well, the shield generator.
These blaster rifles are moving in. Mine works.
Well, that worked. That's an arm. It's not really Star Wars until someone loses an arm. Oops, I wasn't trying to aim for that. Oh, hi. Now watch this one. Oh, he's dead. He got up into my lightsaber. Wasn't what I was going for, but I will take it. Oh. I thought it was as simple as shoot or blow those up, but... Okay. Now watch this. Just fling him off the side like that. With your force grip. Auto aims. He lasted a long time for not having a head.
Maybe if I can shut off the power to that thing. It's powered down. It's offline.
Of course it's offline. I just powered everything down. Now, does anybody remember what quick save is? Oh, quick save's on F12, which also just...
I gotta wait.
No, I thought I heard something. Could have been something, could have been nothing. No, we gotta push the button to go up. Never mind. Lightsaber got him.
Surrender or die!
Wait, is he talking to me or is he just advising himself? Force jump. Well, he ain't going to be in Jedi Knight 3. I would... Oh, that doesn't go down. Okay, that's fine. We should probably go down. Unless we can get through. Oh, we can get through. Okay. Because we should probably go down and make sure that the guy was carrying anything important. But, eh, we'll be fine. Some supply pickups. Now. Oh.
Did you hear something?
No, I didn't. This is just amusing, solely for all the dismemberment that I am causing. Whether accidentally or intentionally. I just kind of wish I had a bit more opportunity to, you know, blow them up before, or, you know, use some fun force abilities on them before I, carve them up. Now, we are not parked down there. This must not be... Hangar 2. Oh. And I feel like in Revenge of the Sith... Oh, there's the Raven's Claw. Remember Revenge of the Sith when, on the, I'm assuming it was on the Malevolence. Now, it wouldn't have been the Malevolence, because that was very early in the Clone Wars run. But, so on Grievous' ship, how Obi-Wan and Anakin, or I guess Obi-Wan mostly, had to deal with...
I sense a disturbance in the Force, but there's something strange about it.
Oh, we got a checkpoint as well as to the quick save. No, so what ended up happening was, on Revenge of the Sith, remember Obi-Wan and the B-2s, and he just, like, twirled his lightsaber a little bit and, like, chopped them up little tiny pieces. I feel like that is what I did. Ooh!
I sense you, Jedi.
We get this in the demo. Nice. This should be fun. Alright, let's see how good I am. I'm a little rusty. Right? Oh, come on, that's... Pansy.
You fear me.
Oh. Clash? A clash? Combat was just a little... Ah, that's usually a good move. That's usually a safe move to pick up a... Oh, tagged him there. Ah, couldn't get the rolling slash in, or the rolling stab. That's pretty... Oh, come on. Ooh, he tagged me good there.
You are a coward.
I'm really, really hurting him now. Oh, I think I got him here. I think I got him here. Yep, I think I got him there. Oh, sorry, I'll take that gun. Yeah. No. Oh. I guess I did enough damage to him already. I was gonna try lobbing him up in the air and seeing what happened. Well, I know what would happen, but... Alright, I guess we're going this way. This one's ways of telling you where to go. Oh! Missed.
Stop where you are!
That works.
Took you long enough.
I do believe we took care of things.
Let's move!
And a hasty retreat.
We get out of this alive, or might be never get out again.
Can't take out the entire remnants all by yourself, all at one time. Yeah, that was Jedi Knight 2 Jedi Outcast. Oh yes, they mentioned the multiplayer in the back. Man, I remember a bit of the multiplayer. I played a lot more Academy multiplayer. But like I said, I really liked that. Played a lot of multiplayer in Academy. Used to... I think I mentioned a few times, but I was an okay hand at that. But yeah, no, this game I have played, absolutely spectacular. This is one of the best Star Wars games ever made, bar none. So I think, so if you're a Star Wars fan and you haven't played it, go back and play it, because it's actually a whole metric shit ton of fun. I absolutely adore Jedi Outcast. Comes with the absolute highest recommendation. I will do a video about that in the not too distant future. But that is it for games over the course of 6 years, from 2000 to 2005. There's some fun ones in there, some questionable ones, especially at the beginning. But LEGO was okay. Outcast was damned good. I had a good time putting this one together and playing some old Star Wars games as we were right around the Rise of Skywalker time. So hopefully you enjoyed this. Hopefully you enjoyed the movie. I haven't seen it yet, so I'm hoping it's going to be good. I already know it's going to be divisive just based off the last movie. But anyway, that's it for this episode of Demonstration Derby. But until we see you again for more Demonstration Derby, more Star Wars, I'm Unsilent. Thanks very much for joining me. Like the video if you liked it. Subscribe if you're new. Share on social media. Follow on social media. The social media handle is Unsilent on air. And that is for Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and Tumblr. And don't forget, Chancellor, Star Wars is our speciality. We've got playlists on the screen in the description down below, and more videos anytime on the channel page. And until the next time, I'm Unsilent. Thanks very much for joining me. Like, share, subscribe, and we'll see you next time.